can. Not too tight.
Shot.
Two great guards by Lorene.
Oh, yikes.
I pretty well said
yeah.
it.
Into the five.
Yeah.
Okay, it's got to throw peel at this one. Peel weight.
Getting her own into the two stones.
Jan Becker.
Oh. Oh.
Get an angle on shot rock? Not quite.
No.
Good try.
Well, I think we'll play this one. Kind of play.
At Houston Stone, sitting on the button, was the second stone thrown by Carrie Kirby Burgess, and it's still there, like it was glued there.
Another guard. It's coming with the swinging turn this time, Linda.
Is it still 24 on the halfway? Yeah.
Once again, that's a good example of how important it is for the front ends to be in the game, be taking the times at all times.
Right,
your skip turns
it,
to you
actually.
For reassurance of the time. And if you don't know, you shouldn't be answering. And in this case, they assure her, yes, it's the same out there. They've thrown a couple out there themselves, so they...
Let her know, guys. It's
important. Where is it?
Yeah.
Okay, well.
First stone for Heather Houston. Skip stones here in seven.
Yep.
Looking to steal if she can.
No,
are we going
yet?
Yet?
Hurry! Hard!
Just a little heavy. They're trying to avoid spilling the guard.
Whoa. Gotta know, eh?
Yeah, that's just lack of experience right there.
That's the seven.
They had to tell Lorene, where is it? They were playing the guard.
I thought it was tight. That's okay. I didn't make too much of a mess. She might play the run back double. And...
Seven.
He's going to draw around there again, eh?
Yeah.
We just have to get it off the pin. I don't mind if she draws around there again. Yeah, timeout.
First for Sandra Schmerler.
Heather's really nice. Really nice, soft
person. She's just throwing like three perfect guards on that thing, so the chances she probably will be able to do it again.
Well, which one, on the center line or the seven?
Even if I knows it, I'm gonna have a shot, right?
Deciding which one to run back.
We can't nose it though, we have to hit it a bit high.
Yeah.
Okay.
Coming into it gets it.
Yeah. Gotta get that off the pin.
Yeah, that's all we need to do. Yeah. Whatever you're comfortable with.
Well, I don't like anything.
Sandra Schmerler.
Yep.
First stone.
Yes!
Yes! Angle raised to get them both. Catch a corner, no.
Left it too long.
That stone just won't be moved.
Well, we can go this way then. My first one would have curled. My first one would have come across it. Don't take too long.
I got a millimeter.
My four.
You've got to protect against the rays of this stone. So you've got to get it into this area here to take away that rays. She played this way. Options, but you have to go too wide to play it. So
to guard the shot she just threw.
She'll just go over, play
I mean,
the other
she
turn,
missed it by a
go that way. Rightly so.
Half a second left. What did I throw?
Talking about the weight, she's playing the opposite turn from the last card, so they need to be clear on how much weight to throw on this one.
How much?
Sandra Schmirler had said that
clean it.
Didn't think that Heather Houston would miss her guard.
She's curling too much.
They made three straight perfect guards.
No.
Look at this one go.
Just over. All right.
Shot.
Worked out pretty well. Almost did curl too much, though.
Wow.
So do you go for the run back possible on the blue for two?
Can we?
Oh, I think so, yeah.
With the intern? The intern?
Well, yeah. 3/4 of a stone almost, eh?
With the in though, or the out? Out's kind of tough, isn't it?
No.
Gonna play the intern on this. It's come across the face. And this stone, try and catch
two-thirds,
it about there,
yeah.
Which would drive it back into that area, and if you make it perfect,
like this?
You could score two.
$5,800 is the skin.
I like this.
Know what else she has, do you, Linda?
She could try the run back on the center line stone, but that's the opponent's stone. This is the chance for the skin.
And for the carryover.
Do I need lots of weight here, or?
Oh, I think just normal.
Just normal?
Yeah.
She could play the white one right back, as Linda suggests, and try and peel it off the center and get the carryover.
Final stone.
The thing about this shot, we haven't played out here a lot. It's got to come a long way.
Get over, you dumb thing!
Is it listening? No, it's not. And remarkably, that stone that Carrie Kirby Burgess put there with her second shot has remained and has given Heather Houston the steal of $5,800 here in the seventh end. Still more when we come back to Thunder Bay. Thunder Bay is a city of contrasts, a modern and sophisticated urban center, but still very close to some of the most beautiful natural scenery in Canada. Majestic mountains, lakes, and wilderness. And just outside Thunder Bay is where Terry Fox's courageous marathon of hope across Canada came to an end. Thunder Bay also home to Fort William, the world's largest reconstructed fur trading post of the early 1800s. And with the holiday season upon us, Thunder Bay is in the spirit Vanderweese Nursery. Has their 50,000 light festival of lights. In fact, everywhere you go, Thunder Bay sparkles with the holiday spirit. Thunder Bay also boasts the brand new, beautiful tournament center where we are this weekend. Yes, Thunder Bay is spectacular, superior by nature. Olay, olay. Heather Houston just picked up $5,800. Ole, ole. And so she's moved in front now, comfortably over Sandra Schmirler. We play for $3,200 now in the eighth. And once again, Schmirler has last rock. And Carrie Kirby Burgess with her first stone. As Houston will try to steal again.
Well, and when your closing comments in the last end, Vic, were so so true. She made a great guard just a few feet from the
right
rings.
Back.
And then
top
she made
four.
The great come around. This is going to come right in, this one,
right back.
To the top of the forefoot.
As far as it'll go. Okay,
good shot.
But it was interesting that last end. I said before the game we were going to track Leeds Rocks and see where they ended up.
at the end of the end, but that one stayed there the whole end. Usually we see the lead rocks out front get tapped, moved around, but that one went in and stayed the whole end, as Vic mentioned, and that was the skin.
They did a great job of guarding it for about 7 or 8. And that's very difficult
very
to do.
Very tough. They played both turns at it. They figured out how to get there.
Hurry! Yeah.
Kathy
Hurry,
Trowell.
Quick! Hurry! Quick! Tight as it'll go! Hurry, hurry, hurry! Quick!
Joan McCusker, Jen Becker. It'll come up short, and now a stone is guarded, sitting, fighting the top four. How long will that stay there?
Well, she was looking to try and freeze to the face of the shot stone, the one sitting in the forefoot. It just came up a little light. Now the guard, trying to angle this guard onto the blue stone.
Yep.
Out in front.
Got out in the boondocks here.
She threw it outside, you heard Heather say.
Way out there.
Right up, guys.
Lorraine's laughing at this one.
Close this little...
You can bump into the boards, it's so far over.
Right up, right up, right up, right up, right up, right up. Oh, hurry! Okay, sweep it, guys.
Okay.
She got it, just got it way outside. The weight was okay.
Throw back four. Okay.
She just lined herself up a little wide, or maybe lined up online, but came out wide, and she just got out there. She didn't seem to do anything with it, so she just lined up straight wide and threw it out there. It never came back.
Okay.
Out in the boondocks,
maybe, maybe more than
Heather
back
Houston
four.
Called it.
Head away.
Playing the raise.
Head away.
T-line.
T-line. Hurry. Hurry. Quick. Hurry.
Yep.
Hey, that's good.
That's fine.
Yeah, just got them both in.
Liz Kingston.
Line's tight. Where is it?
Halfway.
Well then. Looks more than halfway, no?
Well, no.
Close. Okay, no, all by itself. Yep. Yep. Right up. Okay. Let's go down. Right here.
You can see what Sandra's trying to do. She has two blues that might potentially be used. She's putting another one in near the face of the shot stone. Gradually building up a position in the control area, top of the house.
Line's okay, gotta be top. Line's good, gotta be here. Okay, room, room. Whoa, 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 whoa.
She's not behind it. She's not behind it.
That's good. Shot.
Gotta move that one.
Yeah, Heather's gotta hit that. That's a perfect spot.
From Gary Dominic in Aurora, Ontario, if this format really is 10 mini games,
right,
as you suggest, why not give each team 7 to 8 minutes on the clock each end?
You want to hit it?
Well, it's an interesting question. Of course, the 67 minutes plus three timeouts works to about 70 minutes, 10 ends. That's about 7 minutes per end. But the theory is if you take a little longer one end because it gets complicated, you kind of next end can bank some time. So we feel it's more up to the team to determine how long to take each end.
Bumper.
So they've never really gone to that format.
Yeah, that's a good point. I never thought of that, Linda.
Really,
you could take 5 minutes to play one, as you suggest. But you need that nine or ten to play another. So, what the time clock does is it accomplishes exactly what we wanted it to do.
Right.
Actually, Doug Maxwell was the first to use that a number of years ago, and games used to go 3 hours, 3.5 hours. It was ridiculous.
That's the added pressure of the clock too. It comes into play, and in fact, it may be coming to play before this game is over.
What a nice shot that was. Ooh.
Lovely shot. And just to finish that point, the clocks were not meant to speed a person through a game so that they couldn't use all the tactics. And in this game, there are lots of ends where you do get very complicated and you do need that little bit of extra time.
How much
time.
Of it can you see? Yeah, both there. I don't think we can play this with an in turn.
No. You have to play the out turn.
Yeah. It was a boat there.
Okay, let's throw a... back bumper. No.
What is this getting us, though?
Throw hack. Hack, wait.
Jan's comment was, what is this getting us, Linda?
Well, it's coming across the face. She hopes she can drive it back onto that white one.
White's close.
The angle is very tough.
Never.
I know what Jan's saying. It's not a great angle to get it shot rock.
I don't think you can get it at shot. You can get it at second shot, can't you?
Yeah, I guess as I was saying, that's Jen's point. It's not a good angle to get near that center line area.
Okay, good
way. See how tough that was to even get it near the top 12-foot rock. Because the option was maybe to peel off that long guard.
Okay.
She's going to put it in here, but she maybe should be worrying about this one.
Heather Houston is line two, looking to steal this $3,200 skin.
Lots of room. Yep.
Heather Schmerler.
Whoa. Wait only.
Needs to score
two. Wait only.
To win the money.
Yep. Right up, guys, hard. Whoa.
Bonk it.
Whoa. Good shot. Okay, all you hit three quarters. Actually, hit half of it's good. I think with normal.
Okay, I don't know if I can quite hit half, but.
The angle's better with the stone the way it is now.
This should be good, I think, with normal.
Jan Bittker.
That was an interesting call by Heather. There was a couple of things. Heather could have come block this off.
Well,
it's gone half.
Yeah. Good shot.
Very good shot.
Gets the second shot, Stone.
That's all she can do out of that.
It's interesting to note the time clocks. Oh, I guess we'd think about maybe two ends ago. It was about a minute and a half difference.
Well,
and now they're exactly the same, Linda.
That
was a difficult end of Schmerler's.
Yeah, that's right.
Eat up a lot of time.
You want that? It's fine.
Don't you think?
Okay.
I like the guard.
All right. You know how to get there?
Well, are we going to be tight to the center?
Yeah.
You could play.
What do you guys like?
Couldn't you play the hit here?
Call a timeout if you're coming down here.
No, okay. So real light, eh? Just get it over.
I don't know about this.
Playing a guard, trying to prevent the one raise possibilities,
itself,
but Ray's just showed us there is still a rock that can be used on the side to get
just
a shot.
Just let it get
rock.
Over then.
Just get it over.
Oh, just over then. It's curling too much. Yep. Yep. Yep.
Hurry.
Pop it
get a ball.
Bit.
Hurry.
Good shot.
You know how I feel with those guards, but I know it's a steel game and it's 10 mini little ends. We just talked about that.
Do that pretty late.
She's got to play it now.
This is the only thing. Yeah.
Well, why not?
Well,
yeah. You've always got this one.
Can't really do anything with that.
Jan is saying, let's run this one now.
This way?
Yeah.
Well,
you've always got
normal later peel.
Always got this one here.
Peel. Whoa, I just threw that awful.
Didn't like the way she threw it. Jan Bittker.
Whoa. I got this one.
Okay. Needed to be a little thinner if she wanted to try and move the blue one back.
If I was Heather, I'd be worrying about that outside one.
What'd you throw on that one?
On that one? 3.5, close to 24, Heather. I think I threw 3.5.
She's playing another guard.
What did you do, remove that one altogether?
You could remove the side one and roll. They're protecting all the way. They're leaving that for Sander. They did look at it. You could hear them briefly talking about the fact that Sander will have that shot.
The thing about that shot is it could be for a skin.
Clean.
Top 12.
Right now, Schmerler has second and third shots, but the angle raise would be still there to give her the two.
Don't line it up, please.
She's playing it short of the house, so that should be fine.
done.
Except that the angle isn't very good.
For the shot down there, I'm not sure. Well, if you hit it right on the nose, it's a little bit different angle. You just don't want to miss it.
Well, she lined it right up now. It looks like
you hit it on the nose.
The rock we were talking about earlier was this one. I would have been hitting that and rolling in myself. Hindsight, of course.
Nose, I think.
No, I definitely don't want to hit on the broom side, Jan, I don't think.
Nose, yeah.
We can hit it down a bit, but not on the broom side. I think normal.
This should react a little more normally because it's not frozen. Frozen rocks, as we mentioned earlier, are tougher to call as far as the way they'll react coming back into the house. Want to hit it on the nose or cross the face to the center line side, if anything?
Yeah, you can't hit it on the outside.
You might want to throw a little bit up, eh?
Then we better take a touch less.
First stone for Sandra Schmerler. $3,200 skin. Could help herself big time right here. Lined up. Oh, they finally get that stone off the forefoot. And she's line two, and that's the two she needs to pick up the skin.
Good shot.
Well, Heather did leave it there, her guard coming so far and lining up right onto the back one. But nice shot by Sandra. Good call, big weight, well played.
You guys could have got that there, right? What did I throw? 23 and a half. Okay, it's got to be full eight, even if the line's lousy. So, that's for you. You're welcome.
Skip just telling the front end that the placement of this is your responsibility.
The hit and roll there, Linda's still available to her. She doesn't want it, doesn't like it.
Well, the problem with the hit and roll, of course, you have to get the exact roll. If you just hit and stay, it's wide open. She's trying to bury this.
Yep! Lots of weight! Yep! Yep! Whoa! Tons of weight!
It's a very nice shot. The fact that it got buried can force Sandra to play the draw.
It's either that or we play that, but
oh no. Great shot.
It was a great shot.
The carryover.
Guess we gotta do that, eh?
Oh yeah. Well,
that's not that easy though, Jan, because
no, but it's easier than playing that.
Yeah, don't forget my don't. Don't forget the carryover possibility. They looked at possibly playing that angle raise for the skin. That's a very tough shot.
Not even to pick it?
What Linda's talking about, but I agree with Jan in this case. I mean, yes, you could make that for a little added line there,
it's
just
to you. If you want
to
play that,
color.
Play this one.
But now it's a draw.
You heard what do you guys like?
This isn't as easy as it looks, though. She just came by that guard. Well, the only thing, huh? Need full four. You have to play the.
Rock's almost fully buried, and it did a
maybe
lot
a little
of
more
curling
then.
At the end,
I think
too.
We need more, too. Yeah.
Sandra's just saying this hole isn't as easy as it looks because it hangs out for a while, and then it makes a big move.
So again, one of those situations where as the brushers, you have to wait till it breaks, and then you have to try and carry it?
Well, definitely there has to be a lot of communication. Heather threw a perfect shot, a little bit deep, but perfect as far as line. Now, Sandra's sweepers have to communicate the weight immediately to the person in the house.
Line's good. Weight only, just for weight. Just for weight.
Line, yeah, line. Whoa,
Kathy Trowell, Joan McCusker.
Straight draw. No backing, no backing, guys.
No backing.
Where are we?
Yes!
Well, yeah. Can't hurt it.
Through, by, all the way down, forced the carryover, lovely draw. Great shot, under an awful lot of pressure. $3,200 worth of pressure. Sandra Schmirler forces the carryover. We'll add $4,000 when we come back. We'll play for $7,200. It's fun to play in Thunder Bay. And this final of the first JVC TSN Women's Skins Game. That we are, the Skins Network, and we've had a great time. Great final so far. We're playing for $7,200 now in this ninth end, and it'll be Heather Houston who has the hammer. She'll try to score the two. Kathy Trowell with the first lead stone.
Well, that was really a terrific draw by Heather, because and the fact that it went deep had really no bearing, because she was in so much trouble to give up the skin there that she had to make that. And all Sandra had was what she did, and was to draw to for her one and get the curve. She could have tried the angle raise for two, but that's a long, long shot, and give up the money if you don't make it. So
I thought, though, by their panic that they thought they were so heavy they might even slide further back than the four.
Yeah, you can detect a little anxiety in their voices, but it looked to me when it came across the hog line that it was, we're not right behind that sheet, so you can't see the line. But
I think that's based partly on the cash. They were just looking at that amount on the board, thinking we've got to get it there.
You got to be kidding.
Dick would be a soprano.
Well, here we go. Look at this. Kathy Trowell puts up the center line guard, and Carrie Kirby Burgess puts it top 8 and covered. You know, you're going to give me the bad rep here as being a little tight.
Oh,
you're
for line.
I'm just,
needs
you
it.
Know, I'm just nice. Having fun with you.
I know that.
Hurry! Hurry! Quick! Hurry!
But now that you've brought it up.
Can I borrow a few bucks?
Nice weight, Kathy.
Oh, top 10 VIX laws. Save your money. Invest your money. Save money for a rainy day. Pi low, sell high. Very good. I like that one. Get many quotes. Mm-hmm. Don't sit in the front seat of a taxi.
I think that was one
renovations.
Of mine.
Renovations. Yes. Penny saved is a penny earned. Good one. Nickel saved is a nickel earned. And buy pants with deep pockets. Ladies and gentlemen of our production team, thank you.
A little chip on the front one, so Heather mentioned to Linda in the interview that she, the steel prospects, and she certainly been playing that way. Heather needs two here now.
Hey, throw normal.
Going after second shot, hit and roll for Joan.
Close.
Joan McCusker.
Yep. Yes! Hurry! Quick! Whoa! That's good, Joan. Shot.
See the call, hit and roll.
Now, with the $7,200 skin available, this is a skin that Sandra Schmirler must have. She cannot give the money away.
Yep.
Can take it, carry it over. But if Houston wins it, she'll win this first JVC TSN Women's Skins Game. A Schmirler skin would mean that the $6,000 available in the final end of play would determine our champion.
Same way, it's good. First one. That's my fault, John. It just didn't move.
Careless. Exchange of stones.
I think in
think this.
Sandra's right. It didn't
work. Hit it.
Play the double. Want to hit it?
Wait till they finish talking here.
Okay, we'll hit it.
It looked like the reaction of a stone that was maybe thrown inside outside, Linda, because it looked, you know, you're on the stick, but if you put them a little inside outside, they don't make that move or start to the curl until they're halfway down the ice.
Whoa. It's like normal.
This one got outside a little bit as well. It's an interesting end.
A little bit more.
Not a lot of rocks in play. A little bit more conservative. And again, you wonder if it's that number on the board that starts to make people open it up a little bit, try not to take too many chances.
Difficult to ignore, huh?
Okay, a lot of room.
$7,200.
Line's really good.
And as you suggested yesterday, there aren't many women's Bonspiels in this country that would have much more, and that is a first prize.
Exactly, this is an amazing amount of money for one end.
Nice one, Jan, super.
Lovely shot. That's a
good one.
From Fort McLeod, Alberta, Jim Hadley. Are the teams winning split evenly, or does the skip take a larger share?
Well, no, some skips might argue that point, but
I would hate to be the skip that takes more than the front end when you get it back to draw to the 4, 8, or 12 foot for a win. Because the brushers would be on strike. No, they split it four ways. It's
we saw Rick Lang and his son here cheering on Mom Lorraine. And in fact, the case of Sandra Schmerler with Marcy Gooderite at home, they've actually worked out a percentage for her of all their winnings this weekend. So she'll receive a percentage.
Right back, as far as
we're going,
hurry.
Every inch, five
every
ways.
Inch
and that's
back.
Common amongst teams that have a fifth player. They work that out in advance.
Back line, just run that into that, okay?
Back line.
Our associate producer, Jim Panusa, suggests that would be a baby bonus then for Marcy.
Very good. Blue onto white.
Shooter.
It's a perfect way.
Yep.
What she asked for, and that's what she got.
Nice shot.
Lovely shot.
Houston looking for two, still has shot stone.
Decision, you hit that blue one right on the nose and make the double.
Normal?
Okay.
Just right on the nose is a good shot.
Okay.
I'll say.
This is where you rely on your third. Lorraine's made a lot of big shots for the team so far this weekend.
None could be bigger than this one.
Yep! Yep!
That's always a good sign, isn't it, Linda?
Yes, no, it's a great
right shot. Right on the nose to get them both. Look at that. Is that something? Oh, yeah.
Yes.
And Rick says, I couldn't make it any better myself. That's your mom.
And look at the shooter staying right in front of shot stone.
I wasn't going to call that one because I didn't have a good look at the house. Good thing, eh? I probably would have called it wrong.
I think she's too hard on herself. This is a great shot. You have to hit it on the nose. I mean, it's just a straight nose hit because the angle's there, but you have to make it. She threw it perfectly. She threw it solid, lots of rotation.
There was no center guard there.
Wow. Same way does it spin?
Sandra's playing the draw between the blue stone in front of the house and the white one top 12 foot, trying to get to the 4 foot.
Line's really good.
Okay, line's room. Okay.
Well, if you can.
Yeah, no, lots of room. No line, guys, none.
Gotta be shit! Line's okay!
Yep.
Good shot.
Got a girl.
Great shot.
I think it may have come out a little bit on the other side. I'm not sure. We'll get a look at it in a minute. If it's exposed on the other side.
Look at that. My goodness.
Do that again, eh?
Yeah. Just like back four. Yeah. See you want to play? Yeah. Okay. Is that enough ice?
That's much more curl, though, than we saw yesterday.
I'm supposed to get in the garden.
Isn't it?
More, for sure.
Yeah, I think especially once it hit the house, it really kept going, whereas before it didn't seem to have that much late movement.
The crowd here sensing that this is a big end for Heather Houston. She could win the championship if she picks up the skin.
A lot of pressure on this young lady right now.
23 on this side? 23.5. Okay, I gotta throw 3.5 then. I don't know, if we got lots, it makes a big difference to the line, okay?
You can hear a pin drop in here.
The focus and the first stone for Heather Houston. Looking to score the two to give her the skin.
Back 12. Whoa, no line. Close.
Now, quickly, trying to drag it by that blue center line guard. Got her, hurry, got her, hurry. They got it by. There it is.
Linda, this is the one thing you talk about so much, and it's so true.
Great shot.
It's so important to communicate the weight, because I think that was, Lorraine was calling it for line, and I think it was a little underthrown. Not much underthrown, but a little bit. And you really had to let Lorraine know that, because they almost lost it.
It really did start to move, but what great action on the stone. Lorraine was ready to sweep it. Beautiful shot.
Great shot.
All Sandra's got is the same shot she had before, drawing to the forefoot through the hole.
And this is for the championship here. Don't get there. Don't at least become second shot. And the championship will belong to Heather Houston.
No, she's got out there. No, got it out.
Now it's got to walk and walk quickly. It won't. $7,200, and Heather Houston, the hometown gal, as they come to their feet here at the Thunder Bay Tournament Center, is your champion of the first JBC TSN Women's Skins Game. This entire team has handled the pressure. They're the champions, and there's still $6,000 on the line in the 10th end. They put on a wonderful battle in this final here in Thunder Bay, but the championship of this first JBC TSN Women's Skins Game belongs to Heather Houston.
Well, Sandra put a beautiful rock into the forefoot, and Heather had to move it. They left it half the distance down the ice, and then suddenly it started to go. Great sweeping by the guard, and nice shot.
Skin worth $7,200, and yes, Houston, we have liftoff, and she has landed so far a pile of cash. $17,400 so far in this game. Another skin of $6,000 is available here in this 10th and final end.
She's just been just very cool. Vic, just very cool. JVC.
Just tight. Just tight. Whoa, whoa, whoa. Shot care.
Well, very good. Just very cool. Kathy Trowell.
Oh. Line's good.
How long did you work on that?
$6,000 here, so it's a lot of money.
Weight's good. Not quite T-line, I don't think. Line's good. Yep. Okay, we're by. We don't need to go. Great weight here. Yep. Nice shot.
Nice shot. You saw Sandra's team at the end of the last end obviously discouraged, but they knew there was a lot of money on the board, and they certainly aren't going to hand it to Heather. They're going to go for it. Very hard this end.
Yeah, lots of weight.
You got room.
Behind the tee line. Oh, maybe not.
Well,
no, I think.
Close, guys.
Oh, it is.
It's like just back four.
Well, we're going to hit the blue one. I didn't think that was possible, but we are. Okay.
All right.
Sandra Schmerler has last like rock, the hammer. We'll try and score the two.
You can just barely feed off.
You can probably throw a back line.
Yeah.
Okay.
Yeah.
Okay. Barely close. Yeah. Close. Oh, grabs up. Oh.
Has caught something. It's not the turning the right way. It's. Yep. Now taking the other handle.
Yes! Hurry! Quick! Hurry! Quick!
It changed turns and made the shot. Almost.
Most people wouldn't have played it like that. Okay.
Singles twice.
Almost made it perfect.
Right there, Liz.
Caught something right out of her hand. Dan's comment was, no, most people wouldn't have played it like that.
Liz Kingston.
Wait only.
This young front end is really held up well, and
they've
Liz and
whoa, guys.
Carrie.
If you can. Whoa, we gotta get across.
It's just tight then.
That's
especially
fine.
Considering
tight's
the
okay.
Cash, as we've sure. Been well, mentioning, this is more cash than you well. Play for in any women's
whoa.
Cash field.
Whoa, well, that's fine.
It's really
whoa,
nice
whoa,
to see
well.
The women
then.
Have a chance to get out there and
okay.
Play skins format, but it is a lot of pressure in.
Well,
with the big fans here too, all the cheering and everything, that front end has been very cool and made lots of shots.
We can do this. If we skinny by, we get that. Okay?
Back.
Back I like
eight.
Hack.
Back. You want to play that much?
Huh?
Okay.
Joan McCusker.
Oh.
Eight's good.
Yeah, yes! Back hurry! Quick! Hurry! Quick! Hurry! Quick!
That's okay.
Out turn draw.
We can't hit that guy, sorry. You have to
no, we don't want to hit it, but you don't like the guard that way?
You want to guard it?
Aren't they just going to tap that one?
We're still going to play this.
Okay.
Yeah, Heather's trying to do
no,
double
okay.
Duty with this.
Well, yeah,
she's trying to come around
it,
into
if we
the
get
house.
One there first, at least that'll help.
All right.
She also wants to try and tuck it. She's seen them curl in here, so she's trying to tuck it a little bit behind the blue and take away the rays.
That's the right call, I think, anyway.
Line's good. Where is it?
I think it's like back four. No.
Close. No, you got room.
Top four.
Okay, just top four, guys.
Whoa,
whoa, whoa.
Whoa. Whoa, it's back.
Charlotte.
All right, good shot. Get one in there.
Tough to squeeze things out, though. You know?
Yeah.
She would have preferred it to be higher.
I like playing the out turn draw there.
Here?
Yeah.
Yeah, it's much too deep. It's
oh,
too
yeah,
bad because
so.
The
can't
line
get shot
was perfect.
There, but here?
I think
we have to, don't we?
Okay, let's go there.
Doesn't matter.
You can throw like back four.
Okay.
How's the way?
Back four.
Go.
Maybe
whoa,
more.
Whoa.
We're way out there.
Can we play the wick off this one?
Well, we're, no, we haven't got nothing
oh.
Yet.
Wick?
No, no, well, no. No, we're like, we're crashing, not wicking.
Okay,
okay
that's fine.
Throw 24.
Here.
guarding the blue stone that could be raised up.
Lorraine Lang. Had a marvelous weekend.
Just halfway?
Yeah.
Yep.
Ricky tried to tell me yesterday that Lorraine turns all the money over to him.
Oh, that's good there, guys.
And I said, not in a million years will you ever see any of that. Yeah.
Fair?
Yeah.
Huh.
Either couldn't protect both sides. Chose to protect the intern side.
Think we can make that with back four weight?
Well,
skinny the guard, you can.
Huh?
You skinny the guard, you can. Let's try that. Back four weight.
Yeah. Yeah, I think she can get by there with enough to. Just got a skinny, this is what she's talking about. Punch that back.
Jan Betker.
Well, close, yeah. Leave that there, Kathy. That's fine.
Still have to throw the guard.
Yeah.
Okay, just the center guard. Same weight or less? A little less, eh?
Wants to guard the stone that's just touching the center line.
Oh, and narrow.
Line's tight.
Really tight.
Really tight?
Yeah.
Like, are we going to hit the blue one to the warp?
It's got a lot of weight. That's what they're worried about.
Well, we're going to hit it. Got to be in between. In between's good. In between's fine.
In between's
no,
very good.
No, all by itself.
Actually, it's very good.
It worked out fine.
Yeah, things are going their way.
If you moved it over away from center line a few inches, it would have lined up onto the blue one because it had so much weight.
Oh, good darn, throw. That's side score a little quicker.
Is it?
Yeah.
That's a good throw. Or I guess you could probably throw back four, I guess.
Yeah, same way as you had.
Sandra needs two for the skin. Right now, she'd just like to get one for the carryover.
Close.
Carryover would be a draw to the button for the $6,000 skin.
Yep. Yep. Whoa.
Got not in here.
Whoa, no, Kathy. No. Sit there. Okay, that works. Good shot.
Trying to set up a couple of possible raises. Now they have the blue one to the right and the blue one near center.
Starting this one here. What Linda was talking about is this one here. This one here.
There's a side of the center line. 24? Yeah, I know. I threw the last guard to.
You're right. It's almost like she does. She gets into that zone, doesn't she? She's able to concentrate, tacks to her front end, settles in, and has great focus.
But we've seen a lot of Heather over the years. You know, in the, you know, 88 and 89 and 90.
Mine's okay.
And she looks solid again on her mechanics when she comes out. Not that she didn't before, but she just looks so confident and solid coming out of there.
Oh, that's good. Good throw.
Onto there, right? Pretty thin. Yeah. Yeah, pretty thin. Just want to move them out of the forefoot, eh? Watch what's happening here, eh?
The interesting thing about Heather's delivery, I don't know if people remember, her broom hand, she used to hold the hand what I call backwards, and now she's changed that one position of her hand, and I meant to ask her about that to see if there was a reason, but she certainly looks balanced, beautifully balanced in her delivery.
Just running into it. I run into those, the one on the button. Got some options here. Just want to get them off the button. We've got it off the top one and the other one.
What is my name?
not throwing peel, but I'm throwing it.
She means she could also chip the guard and perhaps get the same angle if it overcurled.
Normal, maybe. Normal. No. Close.
Sandra Schmirler, her first stone. Desperate to get one. Just to force a carry over now.
She touched the front one.
Got the whip.
Touched them both.
Wow. Suddenly things aren't so desperate anymore.
How about off both of them?
Finally got a break going back your way. Touches the guard just a tiny bit.
Watch this. Hits that. Hits them both.
That'd be a tough one to call. But it worked.
Once in a while.
I didn't see that, she said.
So the one for the carryover is in. There's that other blue stone over on the right-hand side sitting in the 8 foot, Linda, that you pointed out earlier. She might be able to promote that.
Still could hit it into the 4 foot.
That spot, I don't know.
Right there? No, it's not there. I'm pretty sure it's not. I think we have to draw a top four and make it hard for her to get two. Got about 500 different ways of getting in there, but this is.
You can't stop them all, you're right, Heather.
4, 23.
Final stone, 10th for Heather Houston.
Line's all right.
It's not light.
Lots of line.
Back 8.
Whoa.
Whoa.
Back Careful. 8 was the call.
Have really come across.
Well, we said it yesterday. This is
a major movement there. Huh?
Sportsmanlike crowd. They've applauded both skips, all the skips.
Left her with an easier shot than she would have had if we had just thrown the guard, eh? But I wouldn't have. That curled way more than your. Your back 8 shot it.
Is it narrow?
No, I thought you were okay.
So Sandra Schmirler with her final stone has a chance to get in here for the 2 and the 6,000.
$6,000 shot.
There's a white one at the back 4 that's just a piece into the 4 foot. That's the one she needs to beat out.
Let's go. And there's Joe, right? From first end to 10th. Always positive. Let's go. For $6,000. Need a rub. Need a rub. In, roll it in. There it is. Now that's terrific play. $6,000 for Sandra Schmirler, but the champion of this 1996 JVC TSN Women's Skins Game is from right here in Thunder Bay. Heather Houston. Time now for the TSN Turning Point. It's brought to you by Apple Auto Glass.
But with a carryover in the 8th end, $7,200 at stake in the 9th end. Sandra Schmirler made a lovely draw, a come around into the 4 foot. Heather Houston needs a 2 for the skin, and she's playing a tap back, a very quiet shot, and they need it to curl. About halfway down, it starts to break, and it's a great line call and great sweeping to get it by that guard. What a lovely shot. Sandra couldn't get in there, and that was the skin.
And that was the difference that put Heather Houston over the top. She is the champion here in Thunder Bay. A cash donation will be made to the Coaching Association of Canada for the training and development of coaches in amateur sport on behalf of TSN and Apple Auto Glass. The pick of the crop, coast to coast. The closing ceremonies and the handing out of the check when we come back to Thunder Bay. Season's greetings from Thunder Bay. And the Thunder Bay Tournament Center, as a wonderful weekend has come to a conclusion, this first ever JBCTSN Women's Skins game. And may we say, first of all, that's the kind of response we have every time we come to Thunder Bay. Thank you very much, Thunder Bay. Give yourselves a hand. A sold-out weekend for this first ever women's skins game. And no matter where we go, whatever Bonspiel, whatever championship we see across this country, it's not done without the organizers. Congratulations to the organizing committee, and in particular the hundreds of volunteers who have put this first JVCTSN women's skins game together in a very short period of time, a matter of just weeks. So congratulations to them and to the four teams that have provided us with some wonderful entertainment. Connie Laliberti, Marilyn Bodo, Sandra Schmerler, and Heather Houston. To all of them, we thank you. And we look forward to returning again next year. And we look forward as well to being here at the Thunder Bay Tournament Center in 1998 for the World Junior Curling Championships. And I know Thunder Bay will host the world as well. Now let me introduce you to our dignitaries who will participate in the check presentations. Lots of money, $70,000 in total prize money to be handed out. Let me start with Mr. Rick Brace, who is the Executive Vice President and General Manager of TSN. Mr. George Carey's the Marketing Consultant for JVC Canada. One of the co-chairs of the organizing committee, Mr. Cliff Friesen. And his co-chair, Mr. Doug Smith. And Doug, I'll welcome you to say a few words and congratulate you on a wonderful job, sir.
Thank you, Vic. On behalf of the organizing committee and Cliff, our co-chair, and everybody, we want to thank TSN and JVC, first of all, for showing the confidence to come to our community to host the first ever women's skins game. I think with what's occurred this weekend, this event is well launched, and I think it's going to grow and grow and grow. And you're coming back for the 1998 World Juniors, but I say to TSN and JVC, anytime you want to come in our community, we will greet you with open arms and the wonderful hospitality that you've seen this weekend. So we really do appreciate that. Secondly, if I could just thank all the volunteers, because it doesn't happen without them, and you all know who you are, and it's been wonderful on short timelines. Third, I want to thank the teams for the great play, and fourth, the crowd, who obviously lifted Heather to a wonderful limit. You are, no doubt, the most appreciative, enthusiastic, and wonderful crowd in the world. And finally, on behalf of our community, Thunder Bay, if I could say it to the rest of Canada, our slogan is Superior by Nature, and Merry Christmas.
So, shall we tally up things? $70,000 in total prize money. Connie Laliberti will take home $2,000. $7,700 will go home to St. Catharines with Marilyn Bodo. With Sandra Schmerler to Regina, she'll have a happy holiday, I know, taking home $25,600. And to make the official check winning presentation, I call upon George Carey's and the championship team from the Fort William Curling Club here in Thunder Bay, Heather Houston and her team of Lorraine Lang, Liz Kingston, and Carrie Kirby Burgess take home $34,700 in the first JVC TSN Women's Skins Game.
The money team.
Now, Lorraine and Heather, you might as well come over, the two of you, because I'll talk to you first. Now, Linda will talk, and Ray will talk to the others as well. But you have to talk for the money as well, okay? You just can't just curl. Congratulations. That's wonderful. And to do at home.
Yeah, it is, yeah, pretty wonderful, Vic, yeah.
How much did the crowd mean?
Oh, the crowd was wonderful. Right from about Monday last week, everybody I ran into on the street and at work and everywhere was, good luck, you know, we can't wait for the weekend, it's going to be great.
But it could have been also more pressure on you, no?
I didn't know until this weekend. I've never played a big game at home, but I find out that they're terrific, and I enjoy that.
Congratulations.
Thanks.
Now, Larry, we saw Rick here, and Ray and Linda were making the point that you make the shots, the pressure's on the other team. Did you learn it from Rick, or have you taught Rick everything?
Well, I think he helps me out just a tad. But I think he's especially excited. He's had his eye on one of the really large JVC TVs that have been around this weekend.
Very nice. So now he can go out and buy one. In fact, yeah, one of the added bonuses for the four members of the winning team, they'll all receive JVC 14-inch color TVs. So we thank JVC as well. The added bonus. Now, you talk about this front end, because that may have been, I think, people's questioning, possibly, and no disrespect, ladies, the Achilles heel of this team. We didn't know much about them, but they've played very well, and they handled the pressure, too.
Well, I don't think there's any question now. They played great this weekend.
No, indeed do. We do. Liz Kingston and Carrie Kirby-Burgess, congratulations, ladies. Thunder Bay, thank you very much. Happy holidays.
The 1996 JVC TSN Women's Skins Game has been brought to you by JVC. Technically perfect, perfectly simple.
Well, congratulations, of course, to the champion of this first JVC TSN Women's Skins Game from right here in Thunder Bay. Heather Houston and her team taking home $34,700. It started off with a semifinal win over Marilyn Bodo, where she picked up $8,300. Then the final, plus the winner's bonus of $9,000. Add it all up, and that's how you get $34,700 of a possible $70,000. And it was a slow start, but it was the big skin, the big one of $7,200. That came, of course, in nine. That put her over the top. And so Heather Houston withstands the pressure here in Thunder Bay to win right at home. Heather Houston now turns her attention, of course, to playdowns. She seems to be on form. The two-time Canadian, one-time world champion, seems to have the fire back again, playing with a young front end of Carrie Kirby-Burgess, Liz Kingston, but she has the security of knowing she has the veteran Lorraine Lang still at third. It's quite a team from the Fort William Curling Club. Linda, Ray?
Well, you know, it was a great weekend and lots of cash, and I just have to say, it's nice to see JVC, TSN, and all the people here put together such a wonderful event for women curlers. We've seen men's skins for so many years. It's great to see the cash go home, and what a pile of cash it was.
It was tremendous curling, too, especially the last two games in particular, just tremendous games. This game was, I talked to Sandra just briefly after the game, and she's very disappointed, but they put on a great performance. She talked a little bit about her shot in nine that came out. Actually, she thought she had a perfect draw,
right,
and she said it got to the button. It kind of either grabbed and went sideways, and then we said, you know, it's come out the other side. But Heather had to follow up with a great shot. I mean, there were some tremendous shots through the whole weekend, and we know that we've seen it at the Scott Dermott Hearts, we've seen it right across the country, and just these women can just play as well as the men.
And certainly a big season left for both of these teams. They have to go into provincial playdowns, but it bodes well for both of them. A great weekend and really getting ready for the post-Christmas season.
Merry Christmas to Linda. Have a nice Christmas.
Thank you.
And everyone out there, Merry Christmas to you. We'll see you in the new year.
Happy New Year.
Yes, we will. We'll see you in the new year when our season of champions begins the middle of January, when we're in Kindersley, Saskatchewan for the AT&T Canada Mixed Championship, Sunday, January the 19th. It's been a great weekend. Wonderful weekend here in Thunder Bay. Thank you to all the organizers, volunteers. Congratulations to Heather Houston. She's the first winner of the JVC TSN Women's Skins Game. Now on behalf of Linda Moore, Ray Turnbull, and our entire crew, I'm Vic Router. Happy holidays, happy new year, and we'll talk to you again when our season of champions begins in Kindersley, Saskatchewan.